Hi everyone, Steven Weinberg here from CigarTube.tv. We're here at the IPCPR show in Las Vegas, and I stopped by Eddie Terzona's booth. This is your first year at the IPCPR, and you're introducing a new cigar. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Well, we're Terzona Cigars. We've been around since 2004, and we really started coming in, taking it serious, coming into our own about a year and a half ago. I mean, it was a lot for fun, games, show, but not taking it serious. It's just been a joy, passion, and we've just been growing a lot since then.
That's great. So what blends do you have? Where are your cigars made? Tell us a little bit about that.
Our cigars are made at the Guanacan factory, okay, where the Madero cigars are also made. So the Madero's brothers, Carlos and Robert Madero's, okay, their farm. And it's neat. We get tremendous input. Okay, we're able to put so much input on our cigars. And knowing that we've known each other for quite a while, and we know each other pretty good, so well, I'm looking for something like, okay, he's really looking for something, and we get it done. There's no problems between, no hassles, like, that's what he wants. So, I mean, we have a good relationship. We help them out with their product line, because they're more manufacturer, so we're helping the sales with their line. And in turn, you know, they handle our cigars, the manufacturing side, and the distribution, actually.
Right. So your line of cigars, I see you have the Classic XTC 305 and the Revolution 305. Can you tell us a little bit about each one of those and what the cigar smoker will experience with them?
Well, the Classic is a Sumatra Indonesian with Nicaraguan filler and binder. It's going to be a semi-sweet, okay, very toasty. Yeah, that's an everyday, you know, utilitarian cigar for an everyday smoke. I'd say it's mild. Okay, then on the Ecstasy, you're going to have the Sun-Grown Corojo, okay? It's gonna be spicy, okay? But a very clean, sort of like a muted spiciness to it, with a lot of steep toastiness on the back end. I mean, it really has a nice ebb and flow and a blend to it. So then we go to the Revolution 305, which is gonna be that's our next launch. It launches in the fall. We just always do our launches in the fall. And that's gonna be an Ecuadorian Oscuro, Nicaraguan filler and binder, and double Lijero, okay? But the Lijero serves a purpose for flavor, not so much strength.
Okay.
That's how we're using it.
Right.
And then on the 305, it's a very, very full-bodied Maduro. Mm-hmm. Very thick, very heavy, chocolatey nuances, Costa Rican. I like it. You really got to be in the mood for just a heavy cigar like that. But it's a very clean smoking Maduro, not a strong Maduro, but a very bold Maduro.
So you don't have to eat a cow before you smoke it?
Yeah, no, you don't. No, it's very, very pleasant. Now, I would say because of its boldness and strength, I wouldn't, like, don't go smoke it on the golf course.
Right.
Okay, you know, it's probably not the best idea, but it's a very bold, classic Maduro.
Great. Now, the cigar is widely distributed. Can a smoker find it throughout the country now?
Or? For the most part, you know, we're in several states and nowhere near where we'd like to be. But we're growing and we're a small company and we figure, you know, growing at a steady pace is a lot better than just going all out. I mean, we also have means. So, I mean, well, means that can find us economically. So, I mean, just little at a time, little at a time.
Great. Well, Eddie, I wish you luck. The cigars look beautiful. We'll look forward to giving it a try, and you know, best of wishes with the brand, and we'll see you next year then.
Thank you.
All right.
Thanks.
Bye.